Congrats, class of 2020. We love you. Oh my god.
No, I cannot believe.
I still can't believe it.
And two, three!
Class of 2020!
Gonna try it when they tell you that you can't do that, but you will, and you know you're gonna like it when you light a flame. It goes if you set a bomb, it's gonna go. When I see your pretty little face, that I want to know that I don't wanna fall asleep without you.
Advisory during freshman year?
Oh, they're terrible. Where they came in and they just wouldn't shut up.
It was the most difficult class that I had.
I remember sitting at my desk thinking, oh my gosh, I'm gonna have them for 4 years.
They were really rebellious. I don't know where they were coming from, mostly from middle school.
They were really bad. I would want to cry before I would see them. And I think at one point, I even said, like, don't talk to me until sophomore year.
I was right across from the office, so we always got some admin walking in and screaming at us, telling us to be quiet.
It was a little bit difficult in the beginning, and they did try to test me quite a bit.
There was a couple of students I didn't want in my advisory because I teach Summer Bridge, and I got all of them.
And, like, there are teachers who come in, they're just like, oh my god, Mr. Advisor.
I would keep them in for lunch. I would do like the whole like no talking for 20 minutes. They just could not sit there. They had like ants in their pants.
I don't want to suffer you.
I'm pretty sure I broke up a fight.
There were fights. It was just crazy. And I kind of just hid in the corner. I was like, you guys figure it out.
And everybody just kept saying, it's going to get better. It's going to get better. And I was like, when is it going to get better?
But you know what? They turned out to be one of like the best students ever.
They were so shy and quiet, as freshmen normally are.
Nobody wants to talk to each other, everybody's scared, they're even scared of us.
We wanted to welcome them to freshman year with a pizza party the first week of school. Very, very full of energy, just like full of that freshman optimism.
But yeah, they like refused to do the work, especially like during advisory. They thought it was like a chill period.
Yeah, to correct that ASAP.
Daniel singing on the top of his lungs, his like 80s song. Ashley Morrell is
with her crazy laugh.
So in the beginning, they weren't friends. So there was a lot of frenemies and a lot of people that didn't get along. So that was difficult to manage too. And now looking at them, they're like BFFs and they're like hanging out during lunch.
I remember the human knot and how they refused to do it, but I took some pictures, so I'm gonna have that. They refused to do it because they thought they were too cool to touch each other.
Yeah, we won that.
Freshman year, you won.
It was great. Yeah. Definitely getting shade thrown by Ms. Tobago, but it happened.
Wow, that's awesome.
The freshman teachers have a harder time doing it because it's more behavior that they're trying to fix. And so, freshman year, I took my kids to Disneyland.
This is how you make the world a better place.
Small things can make a big impact.
Smile because everyone needs it.
Don't be a bully.
Show your smile. It's beautiful.
Treat others the way you want to be treated.
Stay woke.
We're so proud of how much you've grown, how much you've matured over the years. Thinking back, you will always be the class of 2020, the class of light, the class of joy, the class of hope. You're fighters. You struggle for what you want. You get angry, you're joyful, you don't care who's watching you dance. And we're so proud of you for all that you've done in these hard and unpredictable and unprecedented times. You've stood strong. So maybe that's who you are, the class of strength.
Your heart is beating beside me, it's trying to ignite. Gives off the heat of a sunbeam, even on the coldest night. It's like I'm burning from inside out, and I think I know who to blame. We have a fever that's wild and dangerous, and I wanna dance in the flame.
Sophomore year, we definitely like came together and everybody was really spirited as well. I think we're kind of the underdogs where we try really, really hard, like on the banners and everything and in the spirit games, but we always come in like second or third place, like underneath.
We're not by no means overachievers. We really try though.
Yeah, we're spirited and we try hard.
They found out that I had a pool, or that my parents had a pool, and they were organizing a trip to my parents' house to have a pool party. That was a big thing of, Miss, when are we gonna go to your pool?
Oscar got so excited that he hit the banner by the counselor's office, and then that's how the pink team lost, because we lost like a bunch of points, and everybody was all mad and upset, and I was just like, guys, it's just a game, because they know that I've never been into those games, and I'm just like, you guys need to relax, like, it's okay, do not murder Oscar. Yes,
they were all way more excited because they kind of knew what to expect, so they had a lot of spirit.
I think just being part of the Orange team allowed us to not take the game so seriously.
We had Kayla, Andres, and a few others just like whipping out pancakes the whole time. Everyone just kind of enjoying each other, playing video games. And then when it came time to the game, the Robinson games, like I feel like we had a really good group of people constantly volunteering to be a part of the game. I feel like sophomore year was a rough spot of growth for us.
I think sophomore year in general is just a difficult time.
They thought they were supposed to do whatever they wanted.
They came in knowing everything.
I'm like really mean sometimes.
No, you're not.
I tell them like, if you're not in my mind, you get out of here.
I think that was the first time we actually did a potluck with like within our own little advisory. And it went so bad. People didn't want to bring certain stuff. Everybody wanted like to bring in like utensils. And it's
$5
like,
for pizza.
Yeah. We're not going to eat forks, guys. We need actual food.
They went to the UC Davis trip, right? Yeah. And fortunately, I didn't go because they were stuck. The bus got into an accident with another car and they had to pull over and they didn't get home until like 8. They were making signs because they were hungry, like, can you feed us signs? We're hungry, can somebody give us food? And they were tired, but they made, like, a situation that was difficult to be in, like, something happened, joyful.
Most of our students are that way. They go through a lot of life struggles, obstacles, and they never give up. They're beasts.
Yeah, and they fight.
Yeah, they're fighters and they won't stop. So that's one thing I really love about my students is that I know that whatever they do in life, they're going to be awesome at it because they don't give up and they've already gone through a lot of challenges. And that's what makes a person grow is the challenges that you overcome.
Yeah, and I feel like they learn a lot about advocating for themselves during 10th grade year. They learn courage. They become more confident about like their abilities because freshman year they feel like, man, I don't think I can do high school. Then 10th grade comes and they have Copera, Garcia, Gonzalez, Vanya, and I feel like they do like this curriculum where they empower the students during 10th grade year.
Does it look like I know what I'm doing?
No.
No. Anyone at home out there who's judging me, I'm pregnant. That's my excuse. Pregnant.
I'm gonna need you to raise your glass. I don't care what you put in it. Here's the nights that you can't take back. We live hard, but we love to laugh. We all thought that we'd get rich fast. Hop the plane out for greener grass. Found out the green is cash. Don't compare to the friends at last. See, we won't forget where we came from. The city won't change us. We beat to the same drum. No, we won't forget where we came from. The city can't change us. We beat to the same drum. The same drum. Sunglasses, Red Bull and minivans, and people who had your back when the world didn't understand. See, we won't forget where we came from. The city won't change us. We beat to the same drum. No, we won't forget where we came from. The city can't change us. We beat to the same drum. The same drum.
I have been putting off recording this video, and I finally figured out why. It's because I do not want to say goodbye to you guys. In all the ways you guys annoy me, I still love you. You guys constantly ask me to get you out of class for some weird excuse. With no. You, I'll stay you put me in your burn book, like okay? You would constantly be in my office after I come up from supervision on the street, sitting at my desk, sitting in my chair, and I come in with nowhere to work.
Your love is where I feel alive, my safety and my shelter. Your love is my home. You are the harbor, sit on my shore. You are the shelter.
What are you doing? This is a video.
I think junior year is when I stopped disliking my advisory. And I think they know that too. And I feel kind of bad because, you know, freshman year I left them mid-year because of my maternity leave. Mm-hmm. And then this year for senior year, I'm leaving them again for a good chunk of the year. My advisory is just so, so sweet. And I see, you know, a lot of students like take charge. So even though they're really quiet, I have a lot of quiet leaders in the class, like strong leaders like Ruby, Nada, Wendy. They really hold the advisory together and they make sure that, you know, like we get everything done.
I didn't see the change until probably like mid-junior year.
Yeah, it was definitely way more serious, especially because I had them as students, so like my relationship with them, it was like a shock for them. They're like, Miss, why are you so strict?
Making their own circles and groups of friends, and so many of them were doing like other programs like YBA. I remember Donna would leave, and then Giselle was studying abroad, so she wasn't even in our class. And then I just had many other kids just working like on AP classes, like for your class, and then working in Ms. Ku's class, and they were just so busy doing other stuff that they were barely even in there. And then if they were, they were just so focused on doing their work.
I feel like they felt like more pressure because they know that they had to get their stuff together because senior year was gonna be really tough with like college apps and financial aid. So I feel like the stress mode was on during junior year.
So yeah, they got serious and they were more concerned about their grades. Mm-hmm. And so they did. They actually stepped up to the plate and started doing what they were supposed to do. Mama said, fulfill the prophecy, be something great. Go make a legacy, manifest destiny. Back in the days, we wanted everything, wanted everything. Mama said, burn your biographies, rewrite your history, light up your wildest dreams, museum victories. Every day, we wanted everything, wanted everything. Mama said, don't give up, it's a little complicated, all tied up.
Inspired by you.
And also they inspire me.
I was like, I can actually be myself with them and Saturday make jokes night, and stuff. So.
End of sophomore, junior year, like, it was a completely different energy.
Our bond got stronger as the years went by.
So when you come in now, like, all of them are quietly working. Well, I mean, Ashley is still laughing in the background all the time. Mm-hmm. And Daniel's still singing. I got to know the sweet personalities of, like, Ruby and Bridget and Chelsea and Andrea and, like, all the, like, more quiet kids.
I had taken my advisory students to Six Flags. Yeah, we went to Six Flags. It was, like, a group of us, too. And that's when I found out that I was pregnant because I slept the entire time at Six Flags. And my kids were all like, where's Mr. Ho? And I was in a locker room just knocked out. But like, I feel like my advisory has been there since like my marriage. And they're like part of my family.
You know, like telling me like, hi miss, how are you? Like, how's your day going? That has like evolved me as a person. So then I'm like really grateful about that.
They threw a baby shower for Miss Parker. They threw me a surprise party for my birthday.
Happy birthday!
We all just like talked, we ate together. Randy drank like 30 high C's.
I was super shocked when they did the whole surprise party for my birthday. I was like super scared because I thought that I got a call from Ms. Mateo telling me to go to her office. Damn, today's a day I get fired. Like, this is it.
I don't know, like, you've grown to love your advisory so much where you feel like you have to write the best letter, right?
Because I never thought I was going to get that close to them, and now I'm just kind of like, I don't know what I'm going to do when they leave. Like, I rely on them a lot.
Yeah.
A lot, so.
And so, like, everything that I learned from my advisory is, like, they struggle. You go through life and you're always gonna have challenges, but you're gonna have to learn to overcome them and be triumphant. I know AJR has prepared you to do that. Never forget where you come from. That's gonna empower you to speak up when others that have come from where you've come from will feel empowered too.
I'll watch fear fall with the sunset and see hope rise with the tide. And when the pain is true, sometimes these troubles prove that I'm alive. My eyes are open, my heart is beating, my lungs are full and my body's breathing. I'm moving forward, I found my freedom, I found the life that gave me reason to live. As this dusty road now settles, and I see what living for, every tear that held a broken dream is now shattered.
A lot of serious questions now, like questions I'm just like, I don't know, guys, I'm still trying to figure out life too.
Yeah. Yes, I'm so proud of them.
I'm definitely gonna miss them.
I'm gonna miss them a lot.
No, they're gonna miss us too.
Yeah.
I look around and everybody's just working.
Congratulations, class of 2020.
I just want to give a big shout out to our two counselors.
I want to congrats everyone for their college and university acceptance.
Once a monarch, always a monarch.
It's been a
long day. You're amazing, brilliant, and special people.
You, I can't wait to see what the future holds for everyone.
And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
Damn, who knew? All the planes we flew, good things we've been through. Then I'll be standing right here talking to you about another path. I know we love to hit the road and laugh, but something told me that it wouldn't last. Had to switch up, look at things different, see the bigger picture. Those were the days, hard work forever pays. Now I see you in a better place. See you in a better place. Can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I would do, you were standing there by my side. And now you gon' be with me for the last ride.
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
I see you again.
We've come a long way,
yeah, we came a long way
from where we began.
You know, we started.
Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again.
I'll tell you.
When I see you again.
You both go out your way and the vibe is feeling strong and what's small turn to a friendship turn to a bond and that bond will never be broken, the love will never get lost.
come first, and the line will never be crossed. Established it on our own when that line had to be drawn, and that line is what we reach. So remember me when I'm gone. How can we not talk about family when family's all that we got? Everything I went through, you were standing there by my side, and now you're gonna be with me for the last ride.
Hi, class of 2020. In the words of the late and great Toni Morrison, you are your best thing. Never forget that. Congrats.
Hi, Seeger.
Congratulations to the bravest young adults I know.
Congratulations.
Congratulations, Monarchs, class of 2020.
Congratulations, class of 2020.
Class of 2020, just know, we are gonna miss seeing you in your cap and gown on graduation day, and we know that day will come, but please don't let that discourage you.
Class of 2020, congratulations on graduating.
Congratulations, class of 2020.
Congratulations, seniors.
Congratulations on your graduation.
I just wanna wish you all the best.
So proud of you.
I'm very proud of every single one of you.
I'm super proud of you.
We're all so proud of you.
We're so proud of you.
I know you guys are going to do awesome things in your lives.
So many wonderful things await you in your future.
I wish you the best of luck.
You know, unfortunately, we didn't end the school year the way we had all planned.
You're an amazing group of students.
You're certainly a memorable group of kids, and I wish we could celebrate with you in person.
I'm sorry we don't get to celebrate in person.
But hey, you know, life sometimes just is out of our control.
Life is often messy, so please, don't expect perfection.
Please know that your AJR staff cares about you deeply.
And believe me, it's not gonna get any easier, but it's gonna matter how you deal with it, how you go through what's coming up next.
If you're too comfortable, you're not pushing yourself.
Life is gonna be crazy, it always will be.
Don't be afraid to feel lost or make a mess.
Know that everything may seem like it's going wrong, but it'll always work out in the end.
You'll find your way, and it'll be great.
At the end of all this, it's your experience that turns you into a powerful leader.
But every single one of you is very strong, and you have to believe that. Believe it in your heart, because we do.
Remember, guys, to turn all your negatives into positives.
But if anybody can turn this negative situation into a positive, it's you guys.
When you take each opportunity and use it to grow and challenge yourself, that is what's going to set you apart.
You will be successful. You are a monarch. Don't you ever forget it.
Never forget where you came from.
Remember, you're in control of your destiny.
So we know you've got this, class of 2020.
Class of 2020. Don't forget, we're counting on you.
Congratulations, class of 2020. Just remember, this situation sucks, but you don't.
Class of 2020.
Monarchs forever.
We love you. Please make smart choices.
Once a monarch, always a monarch.
I wish you the best next year.
You will be missed.
We'll miss you.
Remember to listen to people.
Love each other.
Be brave.
Make sure to think critically.
Keep working hard.
Please don't ever forget that.
Stay in contact. Just remember, once a monarch, always a monarch.
You are resilient.
Keep striving.
Be safe.
Ask for help.
You are strong.
You're bold.
You're courageous.
You are dedicated.
You inspire others.
You can make it through it.
And most important of all, you have the kindest hearts.
Have fun.
Life is tough, but you're tougher.
Read your books.
You are oh so special.
Even through the computer screen, you uplift me.
Keep lifting each other up.
Go to office hours.
Be happy.
Lift yourself up.
Stay in touch with your friends.
Can't wait to see all the places you will go.
Fight the fight.
Be proud.
Don't forget where you come from.
Be brave.
Be awesome.
Continue to make the world a better place with your positivity.
Be you.
Kid, you'll move mountains.
And remember to raise the roof.
And I have no doubt you'll excel and make us proud.
We love you. We love you.
I hope that you come back to AJR and visit all of us very soon.
Don't forget to visit.
And I hope to see you guys later.
And always come back to the community that needs you the most.
No matter how close or how far you will be traveling to go to college, you can always come back to AJR. It will always be your second home.
We'll see you when we see you. Can't wait to give you all big hugs.
Si se puede.
We love you.
And we hope to see you all very soon.
I'll see you next year at the reunion.
We wish you the best of luck.
Congrats again.
Bye.
Sometimes life can feel so unkind.
You're gonna encounter various difficulties in your life. Fight through it.
Just make sure that you stay tenacious and persistent.
Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way.